A very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the concert this afternoon. Before I introduce today's performers, I just want to give a few quick notes about upcoming events. Following today's concert at 2:30 in the Gifford Room, we have our music talk with Michael Koenig, who is talking about global aspects of British organ culture. All are very welcome. On Saturday, we have the Chapel Choir, the In Remembrance concert, and on Sunday here, we have the St. Andrews concert series, a concert put together by Maxi Martin, our honorary professor of woodwind, and for the very first time on that concert series, students are joining in with Maxi, Philip Hyam, and Scott Mitchell for a performance of a wonderful sextet by Martineau. But for today's concert, we have three of our associate teachers. We have 29 associate teachers here at the university, all of whom commit and give a huge amount of their skill and energy to our students. And today we hear from them as a trio. Please welcome Andrew, Joanna, and Robin.
To share our programme today. The Heisenberg Ensemble has been part of the landscape of St Andrews for over 25 years under the directorship of Gillian Craig. Andrew and Robin and I have been playing in the ensemble for, I'll just say, decades with an S. And Jill suggested that we formed a trio last year. So we've been really enjoying doing that and sticking to the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, after which the ensemble is named, borrowed from quantum physics, which states that a certain level of uncertainty is present at the most fundamental level of nature. And we tend to stick to that in all of our rehearsals. Sibelius string trio in G minor. He wrote it in his 20s, possibly whilst still at the Helsinki Music Institute. He wrote quite a lot of chamber music in his youth, but kept most of it to himself. A lot of it was for his brother and sister and he to play together. Not until his family donated the manuscripts they had in 1982 to Helsinki University were many of these pieces discovered. This lento is one movement of a trio that was never finished. And it comes at the end of this youthful period of writing chamber music and at the beginning of him venturing into the large-scale orchestral works of Sibelius that we all know so well. It has an orchestral quality to it, though, even though there are only three of us. He makes a huge texture out of that somehow. And we start to hear a few typical Sibelius techniques. We start with crescendi and sforzandi, rather like Finlandia. There are the hallmark Sibelius triplets, a pedal point, a constant note underneath the other parts. And he takes a very small amount of melodic and rhythmic material and develops it throughout the movement in one arch and then ending very, very softly.
Thank you. Pēterisk Vasks was born in Latvia in 1946. He was the son of a Baptist pastor, and he grew up with the music of that tradition. When he was in his 20s, early 20s, he earned his living as an orchestral double bass player, and subsequent to that, he studied composition formally. His music, his mature music, he takes his inspiration from the northern skies, northern forests, seas, bird song, Latvian folklore, and there's quite often a contemplative air to be found in his works, certainly in this piece. And of this piece, he has written: "This composition for violin and cello was composed in 2013 following a suggestion by the cellist Sol Gabetta. At the beginning of 2014, I spent some time at a house of meditation in an isolated location on the Baltic, where I found inspiration for the name of the work, in veneration of Saint Teresa of Avila. The piece is entitled Castillo Interior. This title refers to her book Moradas del Castillo Interior, Dwellings of the Interior Castle, written in 1577, and considered as the magnum opus of this great mystic." So apologies, a certain amount of sheet music choreography required for this concert.
Thank you.
So to Hungary, Hungarian composer Ernst von Dohnányi and his Serenade in C major, opus 10. Like Sibelius's piece, also a youthful piece, written in his 20s in 1902, premiered in Vienna 1904. Dohnányi's composing style had been heavily influenced by Brahms until this time, but in this piece he's beginning to move towards a more personal language, and we hear hints of the Hungarian folk music that his younger Hungarian colleagues Bartok and Kodály would go on to explore further. The trio is in five movements, beginning with a march, whose themes appear in some form or another in all of the other movements. The second theme in the march has the character of the Magyar people, who migrated from the Ural Mountains in Russia to Hungary in the 9th century. A beautiful romance follows, and then a scherzo vivace with a fugal flavour. There has been much discussion amongst us about how vivace is vivace, and I didn't win. I was the one who was chicken, by the way. A theme with five variations is next, and then a rondo, at which the end of the Magyar melody comes back from the first movement, bringing unity to the whole structure. We've found this a most fresh and engaging piece to play. We've really enjoyed the interaction between the instruments and the reinvention of the material as it goes through the piece.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.